So I wasn't expecting this room to be coming.
Okay, so if you need anything right now, fresh coffee, drinks or something, please do that right now. Come on.
Sorry, I'm going to try to sit back here and film this.
Oh my God.
She was just writing it straight down the ticket.
Yeah,
I mean,
I really enjoyed supporting you. I wish you would have turned out
here.
We learned a lot.
Two sets of utensils.
No, this is my.
There's your bacon.
I'm going to get one.
That's okay. Festivities, and we'll let the staff come in as they need. This is our cozy space. It's finding space can be difficult, and it's nice to have breakfast. My name is Paul Judge. I'm a strategy director for one of two strategy directors for ABB. And this is Bob Wood, who chairs us. I'm going to let all our speakers introduce themselves as we get forward in the interest of time. We'll do a couple formalities to get the ball rolling, and then we'll go from the park admin stuff goes, the front exit's the closest exit, so please, we're going to have to go out real orderly, like if something happens, you know, military guys, we got to prove that stuff. So, and I'm not going to give you the history of ABB, Bob will do that later, but we want to talk to you all about what we need to do to win, and the 7th especially, and we're forming regional teams, 7 and 8. I'm from the 8th. So I'll be trying to muster up some folks to come down here and help the 7th rally and vice versa. If we have something we need to do up there, if we have a target audience up there, if we need some vets to help us make presence up in the 8th, we would do the reverse. And we've done this all over the state now. Okay, so Bob will get into more of that later. So this is the kickoff event for us, because for us, it's a 365 adventure to get to Election Day. It's not this stand up a month prior and hope for the best. So we're deep into data, we're deep into veteran analysis, we're deep into getting every veteran in Virginia to vote. All right, that's the baseline for us. We figure if we get 100% of veterans to vote, well over 700,000, there's a couple different numbers out there, we think they come in center right. All right, so we don't care. You can go, we just want you at the polls vote. We'll figure out the rest from there. Because we can see, and every veteran who thinks their vote doesn't count, I'm here to tell you, I mean, I've just learned over the last 2 years, it counts, because post-election analysis is, you know, is important, and they see what veterans are stepping out, which veterans aren't, and we see that now, that we've been able to get our hands on the ground. Okay, so with that, we got to do a couple things. Where's Rich? We're going to do a prayer, a pledge, and let you hear our code of conduct that we have our members sign up to, because we're just trying to continue our service after we retire, right? Through the election process, because we all take an oath, and it doesn't really end when you retire, right? So let's start. Rich, if you'll do a prayer to get us started, and then we'll make you guys stand up and do the pledge with us.
Heavenly Father, thank you for this opportunity to meet these vets and concerned citizens, the patriots. We ask thy blessings on this food that strengthens us and nourishes us. We ask thy blessings on each of us and our families. We ask that you give us the strength and help us to feel the Spirit and to respond to your promptings as we go through our lives. And help us listen and learn from our guests and conversations this day. And please, Heavenly Father, and special blessings for all of those who served before us and gave their all, their families, their friends, and our beloved country. We say this in the name of our Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Jeff, could you lead us in the pledge there, please? It's going to be hard for you guys to stand up. I apologize.
Flags on the roof.
Flags behind you there.
Okay. Hats off. Hand over the heart. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, have your seats, be comfortable. App's going to read you the code of conduct so you know what our members are signing up to when they sign up to be ABB members and then get out there and support candidates.
American veterans vote.
code of conduct, the source of our strength, the reason for our existence, and the judge of our success. I am an American veteran or veteran supporter continuing to lawfully honor my allegiance to the Constitution of the United States, U.S. flag, to the republic for which they stand. I will never forget the sacrifices of those who came before me. I will never do anything to bring dishonor to them, my fellow veterans, or their service to the nation. I will always treat others with dignity and respect, honoring the unique contributions that they bring to the strength of our nation. I will be informed, I will vote, and I will encourage others to engage in civic life of the community in order to preserve our constitutional republic. I will never forget that I'm an American veteran or a veteran supporter responsible for my actions and dedicated to the principles and institutions which made my country free. I will trust in my God, the United States of America.
Cool.
Okay. Great. Bob, do you have any open things you want to talk about?
Well, welcome, everybody. I'm Bob Wood. 3 years ago, Daniel Gade called me and he was running for Senate. And Daniel Gade was one of my company commanders when I commanded the 2nd Infantry. I had run up in the People's Republic of Alexandria for city council. I did that twice. I learned a lot, and I found a lot of people that had common interests with me. We may not have won, but we enjoyed doing the task of involving ourselves in civic duty. So veterans don't really come to politics naturally. They were in the military, they served, and the mission was in. Once you're out, you realize that your community isn't exactly what it once needs to be, what your schools aren't exactly teaching what you want them to teach. Your job is important, maybe thriving the way it should, and other veterans are suffering. How do you change things? We think you change it through the ballot box. We formed that code you just heard on the 8th of January. That was 2 days after the 6th of January. We were all just shaking our head after not quite winning with Daniel Gade, and asked ourselves, what are they so frustrated with? We all knew in our heart what it was about. But we said there's other ways to do it very constructively and continuously to work with our community. So we wrote that code of conduct saying, this is who we are, this is what we believe. And we didn't go away. We've been around for 3 years. Our first, other than Daniel Gade race that we ran was for Heather. She was having a special election that occurred, and we said, well, let's get in it. So we had about 3 days of rest, and we jumped in. You remember how quickly that came about. We didn't think we'd win, but we had great time and fun. We enjoyed each other's company. We said, well, we're going to incorporate. We did. We became a 527. We're also a 501c4. We didn't go away. We started deciding to build our network across the state. Well, that year was a great year that followed. If you recall, some guy named Glenn Yankin found us. Glenn Yankin? Was it Glenn? And he found us and said, would you lead our coalition, a veteran coalition for Virginia and for the Youngster campaign, along with, Winston Sears and the whole ticket and the House delegates. We worked hard. That was a great win. And we continued on to build our network. We've got about 600 members right now across the state and a mailing list of about 17,000 that we just continuously work on. And the point of our whole effort is every veteran, every vote. It's pretty simple. It can get very complex, but from our perspective, three goals: support veterans and their families, right? Defend the Constitution, and secure the nation at home and abroad. So it's great to see some law enforcement candidates and law enforcement people with us. We think those three goals can pretty well wrap together anything any veteran on any given day and any veteran supporter can get behind and support. Those three goals, every veteran, every vote, you get it done day in and day out. We meet 3 times a week on Zoom. We get tired of looking at each other, but we love to see each other in person. All to essentially build out an organization that can get behind candidates who we believe are behind our objectives and promote victory. Of late, it's changed. It's changed a little bit because, as we know, that early vote is something very critical. We're very glad we're on the block. We're glad we're doing it all the time because getting that early vote out is a lot of high touch. It's not the last 6 weeks. We're going to ring every doorbell. No, it's be around for the long haul, and we are around for the long haul. We continue to grow. This is the 2nd of 4 that we're having regional teams because from the top down doesn't work when you're trying to get that kind of breadth in your effort. So you had a great meeting with Jeff. Where are you?
Right here, sir.
Jeff, and he leads the team in Nova West. We also have another team here, which is Nova East, and we have a central region in the Southwest, and Jen Kiggins and all of her crowd down there. So we're happy to be doing this. We're glad you're with us, and we think we're really growing as a as an entity with, I think, the ability to reach out and promote elections and their success. We're about, frankly, winning elections, not always winning arguments. Get off the couch, quit yelling at Fox, and get in the game. And that's what we're doing. And that's what we've done. So we're glad to do that with some people here that I'd like to thank for coming. Those are here to talk about how do you win in this area. We've got some really good experts who've had great experience. So we want to hear a little bit of your perspective. We're going to turn that into success for candidates here in this district. We've got some people coming in. Good. We are, by the way, veterans and veteran supporters. So you don't have to be a veteran, but you can believe in the three objectives I just described. So thank you for those who are going to spend a little time talking to us. I'll let Paul walk through. We do have new faces, and a lot of you know each other. We don't know everybody yet. You may say, hey, is there another candidate in here? If you just kind of stand up and give a quick shot on that. At the end, I want to walk back through, and I'm going to have a discussion at the end. Have you heard what you had to say? We're going to have a discussion about how do we turn this into victory. How do we get, you know, the right people who signed up for absentee ballots or early voting or at the polls or working the polls. Behind the candidates, do what it is they need to be doing. And we got the experience in this room to have that kind of productive discussion. The man with the camera is going to record it all. So we're going to keep track of this. We're going to build out from where we are today. And we're going to do it with a lot of people that I think you know and your rosters and your list. Every veteran we can get involved with this would be great. Again, there's 720,000 veterans in the state of Virginia. 404,000 are voting regularly. We're trying to increase that number to 700. We've got a track record, a background, 3.5 years of experience, and you're not going to be part of the team with us. So thanks for coming. We'll let Paul do your best to manage a lot of people we'd like to speak. We're going to get everybody out of here really about 11:15, and they've got to clear the room to get back to the real business.
Yeah.
Okay.
So
thank you.
And there's a nice for the candidates. There's a generous open discussion period at the end. And then that's where we expect you guys just to pick yourself and let us everybody in the room know who you are and what you're running, okay? But for right now, our mission, like Bob alluded to, is having run around the state a lot, we found out, hey, we don't really, when we enter an area, we really don't understand what's happening on the ground that well, just looking at it from the state level. So we're here to hear what's happening in 7. Crystal, if you have a few minutes, if you could give your perspective on what's going on and what you're thinking right now, it would help us in DVD.
Sure. So for those of you who don't know me, I'm Crystal Vanuch. I actually ran for Congress in the 7th Congressional District and was the chair of the Board of Supervisors for the last 2 years. I am still on the Board of Supervisors. I represent the Rock Hill District. This is my last year of service for that. I will be running for re-election, so I'll be on the ballot November 7th of this year up for re-election on the Board of Supervisors. And I can tell you specifically about Stafford. So obviously I didn't win the primary, so I don't know how good of advice I'm going to give you outside of Stafford County, but I did win every single precinct inside Stafford County. So I can tell you a little bit about boots on the ground and what it's like in Stafford. And it's about mobilization. It's about not showing up on election day. It's about everything that you do to lead up to that. I think that what the other side of the aisle does really, really well is growing their network. They don't wait until 45-day early voting to get people out there and get them to the polls and start asking them to get registered. They're out there right now registering new voters to vote and following up with those candidates that know that they could get behind and giving them the information on those candidates. I think that's one of the key things that's going to be really, really important to winning back the 7th Congressional District and getting local candidates elected. This is going to be a huge year for Stafford County specifically. We have 17 races on the ballot, from state senate all the way down to commissioner of revenue, treasurer, and we have 3 board of supervisor seats up for re-election as well. 2 of them are held by Democrats. We have an opportunity to take the Stafford County board back. One of the candidates here with me today is Deontay Diggs. He's a graduate of VMI and he's running in the George Washington district. So I am fully supporting his campaign because I know that he is a great veteran. He will stand up for the community and he works in the sheriff's office. And I know he's willing to do the hard work as a candidate to get elected to hopefully get the board back under control in Stafford County. Because I can tell you that Stafford is the red line, basically. We barely snuck it out in the congressional race. I think Vega only won this by 1%. So I want to give you guys just my input on what I think we need to do. moving forward into this election. I think getting networked with the candidates is great. I think picking your candidate, getting behind them, and a rising tide raises all ships. Utilizing all of our resources together is going to be incredibly important, and helping all of the candidates on the ballot that support veterans be able to have the resources and the networks that they need. So what can you guys do? If you have veteran friends, you need to be reaching out to them, getting them to join this organization so that they can coordinate with the candidates on outreach to those veterans. I can tell you that one of the most frustrating things as a candidate is when you do door knocking events and nobody shows up, or you have to continue to call the same friends over and over and over again to come out and do the door knocking. Working the farmers markets. I know in the congressional race, for example, I worked the farmers market with my team every single Sunday leading up to the primary. That helped secure the win in Stafford County. We gave that same information to the Vega team, but she couldn't get volunteers to volunteer at any of the farmers markets across the 7th District. So she wasn't able to have a presence there. But do you know who was there? Abigail Spanberger and her team. Every single farmers market, every single Sunday. As a candidate, you can't do it on your own. I worked 23 hours a day. Derek Anderson worked 23 hours a day. I know Matt worked. Matt Strickland's here now. I saw him out of the corner of my eye. You can work as hard as you can as a candidate, but it's never going to be enough. So you guys have to put in the hard work, knocking doors. If you're physically not able, coming in and making phone calls for those candidates from the start of their campaign and telling them what they stand for. It can't be just before the election. And getting money, donating money to candidates is huge. Sometimes people are like, well, you know, I can't give you money. I don't want to donate to a campaign, but I'll help you do this or that. I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, money is the most important thing in a campaign outside of physical activity of knocking doors, because voter contact one-on-one is the most important thing. The second most important thing, or really it's money, because you can pay people to help knock doors, is the money, because you can't do mail, you can't pay people to do phone calls, you can't get across the finish line without funds. So donating to those campaigns is going to be incredibly important. So those are really the key things. It's not rocket science, it really isn't. It's really about actively getting involved and showing up early and often and getting the candidates across the finish line. I think that's really the key and the critical area there. So Stafford County is the home to the most service-connected veterans and veterans in the entire Commonwealth. So Stafford County houses more veterans than any other county in Virginia. So to me, this organization getting out there, I bet almost every other door is a veteran in Stafford County. Now, are they registered to vote? Are they showing up and voting in primaries? Probably not. And I think that's the key, is making sure that they're registered, number one, and that they're registered here, and that they are showing up to vote in primaries and making sure that their voices are heard early on in the process to support the right candidate moving forward to the general election, because that's how we win. And everybody unifying behind that candidate. So I think one of the things, and I don't know if you can do this, but I'm certainly gonna take this as a takeaway as I was listening to you talk about getting contacted with these veterans. You know, we have something in Virginia from, I think it was 2012, I think it was 2010 actually. There was a constitutional amendment that 100% service-connected veterans get a waiver on their personal one car and their real estate property tax. So we actually give we lose $14 million in revenue for that tax relief and for veterans in Stafford County. So that tells you that there is a lot of veterans that are 100% service connected. So one of my follow-ups is going to be to reach out to the Commissioner of Revenue's office to determine if we can get the addresses registered under that, because that would give you guys every single house that is notified. And I know that it's not the people, but I know that there has to be a way that we can find out where these people are. So I will work on my end to try to see what we can find out, but that might be an opportunity to try to contact some of these veterans.
Wish we could call USAA and say, give us your roster.
Yeah.
It's a matter. It's exactly what you're saying. We have to get out as much as we have to work in areas that support candidates. You've got to get out and contact the people in the state. That's where you find your veterans, because they'll recommend five or six people the other time. But it's really a lot like high touch. Plus, we have their voting data from the voting file.